Hello, welcome once again to Stuff and Things, where I like to talk about stuff and occasionally even things. I'm your good friend Bradley, and today is a pleasant Sunday. And on this pleasant Sunday, I am having a little bit of GLP's Westminster. I just recorded a first impressions video of this blend. First impressions are quite good. I'm enjoying this quite a bit. It's an English blend, Oriental forward. You could maybe call it a Balkan. And within that first impressions video, which we'll be posting this coming week, so I guess you'll be watching this first, so maybe you can answer the same question that I asked you in that video. GLP's tried to make this blend as a close approximation of the original Dunhill London mixture, not the Murray's version and not the current Orlick version. And I'm curious, because I never had the original Dunhill London mixture, how close he came. So if you have had both Westminster by GLP's and the original Dunhill London mixture, is it anywhere near what the original was? I know it's maybe hard to remember a blend that was that far back. I think it was late 70s, early 80s when Dunhill stopped their original production. But let me know if he came close, because to me, this is a very tasty blend. I haven't had the Orlick London mixture in quite a while, but it's sort of similar to that, at least in kind of the proportion of component tobaccos. It's Virginias, it's Latakia, it's Orientals. So I'm curious, do you think that GLP's Westminster is anywhere near the original Dunhill London mixture? Now here I am talking about pipes, talking about tobacco, and I know a lot of you are not here for that. You're here for one thing and one thing only. You saw my interpretive dance last week and you were amazed, flabbergasted, awestruck perhaps, maybe slightly turned on. I understand. I understand that's why you're here and that that's what you want, and so here you go. Nope, 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 nope. Cut it. We don't have time for that. I'm sorry, I know that's why you're here. I know that's what you were looking forward to this week, but we have to move on. I have many things to talk about on this week's Sunday Smoke. I hate to do it. I'm sorry, but I have to, because there's been some news. So the Seahawks are not in the playoffs. Don't worry, this will be very quick. And so I'm not really following the playoffs that much. I don't really have a horse in that race. But they made some moves. They fired their offensive coordinator, Daryl Bevel. They fired their offensive line coach, Tom Cable. And it looks like they're gonna be getting rid of their defensive coordinator, Chris Richard. And that could be good, could be bad. They've been kind of, I don't know if I'd say awful on offense, but really inconsistent on offense. The offensive line has not been great for years. Some people say it's because of the personnel they have. Some people say it's because Cable is trying to force a certain blocking scheme that he doesn't have the personnel for. I don't know. I'm not an expert. Change could be good, but now they're rumored to be hiring Brian Schottenheimer for the position of offensive coordinator. And he was the Jets coordinator when they weren't good. He was the Rams coordinator when they weren't good at all. I think they were like, you know, 30th in offense at the time. So is that a good thing? Is that a bad thing? I don't really know. I can only hope that it's an improvement and not just sort of throwing the baby out with the bathwater. But hopefully this offseason, maybe some new personnel, maybe some new coaching, we'll get back on the same page and do better next year. So there you go. Quick and painless Seahawks update. There you go. Motorcycles in the background, hawks flying overhead. That's fine. We're going to power on with our Sundays. My mom called me yesterday and she had a little interesting conversation for me. I don't know how to broach this exactly because I'm going to be sort of taking something for granted, which may not actually be the case, but it seems like for me and for a lot of other people I know, as Americans, and especially Americans of European descent, we often seem to be interested in what our ethnic background is because, you know, America is such a new country, there isn't a lot of history to look back on, and maybe Americans want to feel as though they belong to something, or there is some sort of like through line from history to the present day. So people will talk about like, oh, well, I'm 20% German and 30% Scandinavian and part English and part this. Like, it seems like Americans more than perhaps Europeans will sort of parse their ethnic background, and they find that interesting. And so families often have lore like, oh, well, your grandfather was 1/16th Native American. And we'll talk about that within the family as though that's like an interesting subject. And my mom's side, again, I don't know if how interesting this is for you, but maybe this will spark conversation amongst yourselves and in the comments. My mom's side was always considered to be, or at least we thought we were on my mom's side, mostly English and a little bit of Irish, maybe a little bit of Scottish in there. But her brother, my uncle, took one of those DNA tests that you can get on Amazon.com. It's like Ancestry or something like that, where you swab, get a little saliva, send it in, and they'll send you back and they'll give you a percentage of your ethnic background. So like, oh, you're 10% Iberian Peninsula or something like that. So where your ancestors came from. And I found it interesting because a lot of it matched up with what our family thought. Because basically my mom's side of the family, I did, quite a ways back, I did a whole like Ancestry.com thing where I was trying to trace back my mom's side of the family and go, well, I tried to do my dad's too, but they're more recently came to America and from like Germany and Norway. And so I wasn't able to go back very far, but my mom's side had roots going way, 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 way back to like the original Jamestown colony. So they've been here a long time, or relatively long for Americans anyway, 17th century, 1600s. Anyway, so we had thought that we were mostly English, mostly Irish, or mostly English with a little bit of Irish and Scottish. And so my uncle got these DNA results, and it turns out, I think we were 25%, so this is my one half of me, so I guess 12.5%, Scandinavian. Let's just make this easy. My mom is 25% Scandinavian, and she was very shocked by this because she thought she was English. But it made sense to me because there have been so many, I guess, waves of Scandinavian conquest in the British Isles. You know, the Danes and the Norwegians and all those Vikings were coming and smacking around the English people, or the original, like, Anglo-Saxons. There are a lot of Scandinavian place names and stuff in England. And then also with the Norman conquest, the, you know, William the Conqueror, 1066, Battle of Hastings, all that good stuff. The Normans were Scandinavians who had settled in Normandy in France. And so by the time they were conquering England in 1066, they were pretty much Francified. They were speaking Old French, but they were ethnically Scandinavian, basically. So there's all sorts of admixture there. So I think she said she was 25% Scandinavian and then mostly English and some Irish, some Scottish. But then she was also shocked, and not in a bad way, but just surprised that I think she was like 1% European Jew and then 1% Middle Eastern as well, which was interesting. But it was just a fun conversation to have with her to find out how closely our family lore sort of matched with scientific fact. And now I'm curious to do it myself because, like I said, my dad's side of the family, I think both of his parents were the first generation born in the US. So both my great grandparents were born outside of the US. I think my dad's dad was German. My dad's mom was Norwegian, or at least their parents were respectively Germany and Norway. And then my grandparents were the first ones born in the US. Anyway, so it seems like that's a little more clear cut, but I'd still be curious to know if on my dad's side, I really am 50% German, 50% Norwegian. And then with the other Scandinavian from my mom's side, it looks like I'm, if any block of anything, it seems like I'm mostly Scandinavian. But anyway, would that be something interesting for you to watch on the channel? If I were to come up with my own percentages, what I think I am, write them down and then take one of those tests and then reveal what I am. I could be like, I'm like 30% African-American, yo. You didn't even know that. Neither did I. What else? Damn it. I'm looking at the timer here, and I don't think I have time to do the Ask Stefan Things segment. Again, if you have a question for me, I try to pull some from the comments. I try to pull some from YouTube messages, but for the most part, most of the Ask Stuff and Things questions come from Twitter. So if you at SAT Pratt, I don't know why I have so much trouble with this, at SAT Bradley, hashtag Ask Stuff and Things. That's the best way, the most efficient way to ask me a question. You are more likely to have it answered there because it's in my face and I can see them, and I can also see them by date and time, and it's more efficient. It works better. So I'm not gonna get to those questions this week. I will take this block of questions and I will move them over to next week and I will answer them then. So if you have a question, at SAT Bradley, hashtag Ask Stuff and Things. I need to take a shower. I need to eat some dinner. I'm gonna go out and shoot some pool with some friends. Dinner. I'll have some chili, maybe a bowl of chili. Some saltine crackers go good with chili. Maybe crumble a couple up, put them in the bowl. Maybe some cheese. I got some good mozzarella. Might have some of that. That sounds good. Maybe a roll. Don't want to get too much bread though. The chile is con carne, so there's a little meat in there, a little bit of protein. I actually have a dessert for myself, which I don't always. Well, I often have a little bit of something sweet, maybe a cookie or two after dinner. But tonight I actually got, okay, we're out of time, but briefly, for those of you who live in the UK or maybe Europe in general, I don't know how popular these are, but there's a Let's Play series, and this isn't the thing that might be popular. There's a Let's Play series that I watch called Prepare to Try. It's made in the UK by, I think, a Welshman, an Englishman, and a pseudo-Irishman. And they're always going off about peanut butter magnums. They're always talking about how they want a peanut butter magnum. And I didn't know what those were until I finally looked them up and I found out that they were some sort of ice cream bar, I think Belgian made, perhaps. And I don't know if they're popular in the UK, really, or if it's just popular with them, but I was like, I want to try one of those peanut butter magnums. They talk about them all the time. Are they available in the US? And then I just happened to walk into my local Fred Meyer, best store ever, and there they were, double peanut butter magnums. So I picked up a box and they were delicious. I loved them. Good ice cream, good peanut butter, chocolate coating over the top of everything. And then I've also tried the double cookies and cream. That was amazing as well. So I actually have a box of double cookies and cream magnums waiting for me. I'm gonna pop one of those bad boys open and I'm gonna devour that thing and it's gonna be delicious. And then I'm gonna go out and shoot some pool, have a few beers, have a good time. But there's a lot of stuff to look forward to on the channel. I'm trying to upgrade my computer still because I'm trying to get some more graphically intensive games that I can also be recording. It's very taxing on the computer to have a really graphically intensive game and then be recording that at the same time because my computer is kind of old, but I'm doing some incremental upgrades, just threw a new graphics card in there, gonna try to get some more RAM and some other stuff going. So look forward to more PC-centric games on the Stuff and Things Plays channel in the future. Might get into The Witcher 3, might get into PUBG, might get into Doom perhaps for that. I'm currently doing Getting Over It with Bennett Foddy, a ridiculous game, but people seem to be liking the series quite a bit. I'm not getting angry, ever, while playing that game. I may not have ripped my shirt off in frustration. I may not have done any of those things. You should check out the series on the Stuff and Things Plays channel. Again, look forward to the first impressions video of GLP's Westminster. Just look forward to a lot more of everything. Maybe more interpretive dance. You never know. But until next week, until we meet again, I've been your good friend Bradley. You've been the audience. This has been Stuff and Things on a pleasant Sunday. I'll see you later. I really gotta go. It's late. Gotta eat. Gotta wash my naked...